This is Shaman Weaver Sheila Baker, and I'm here for East West Books just now. I'm talking about March and the Tarot, and in thinking about March, what I was thinking about was that we've had a long winter, and in winter we do what the bear does. We go into hibernation and we transmute things. We go in, we compost them, we hibernate, we introspect, we reflect on things. And then, you know, along about the first of January, we make these resolutions. So resolution means to resolve. So we've already solved something, but now we're going to resolve it again. And what happens by about March, about now, we're starting to come out of the winter. And we're starting to figure out, well, you know, what's working, what's not working. So here comes the hermit, who does just exactly what I was talking about the bear doing, goes into introspection, and from there brings back the light, spends time on the mountaintop. Sometimes it's called a vision quest in the Native American tradition. So he goes in and introspects, digests, thinks about things, and with a new perspective, you know, goes through the resolution. You know, by about March, we start to think, well, you know, can I give that up? Have I done anything at all about this? So the hermit is the one who holds out the lantern and says, this is the way. Look over here. I've got a way for you. So we're coming out of that time of introspection, of being deep within, back out into the world. So this is a beautiful energy of the hermit in the major arcana. 22 of them in the whole deck of 78, and this one is really useful for March. You know, where are you exactly on track? Where is the light shining? Where do you need to adjust and do something differently? So this is the first card for March. So then, as I was thinking about that, I was thinking, you know, we're coming out of introspection and we're leaving things behind. So this card, and I went to the swords, the element of air, thoughts, and ideas, and putting things into action. So this card called to me. It's the 10. I'm going to hold it closer so you can look at it. And what's happening here is there's a recumbent person. No life is left in this person. The ideas, the thoughts, the way that they were doing things, because thoughts form things, and thoughts become ideas, and we put ideas into action, and then they become things. When that doesn't happen, it just runs around in your mind, and at this point, some of the ideas that we've got are not serving us anymore. You've gone into this particular year, which is 2017, and it's a 1 year. 2 + 0 + 1 + 7 = 10 reduces down to a 1. So we're getting a restart this year of everything. All that old stuff is gone. It's in the past. We need to rethink, come back from the mountaintop, put things into action. And then after we look at this, it's the end of a karmic cycle. So this is true for everyone this year. The old karma is done. We're finished with it. We're starting into a 1 year. So rest and rejuvenate. Come fully present. Use the rest of March to do that. Because the other card that called out to me was the Ace of Swords. I think about this as a gift from the gods. You see here, that's cloud with a hand in it coming up, giving you the crown, and which is blossoming, by the way. So it's bringing new life and new joy. So a brand new beginning in this particular way of being in the world. So a new idea. And when the karmic cycle ends, it clears the slate for all kinds of new ideas to come. So this is a brand new idea that's coming. It might be a project that you put on hold last year, or that you've been even struggling with this year. So it's time to maybe look at it, and are there things about this project or about where you're at right now that it's okay to just wipe the slate clean and start again, brand new cycle karmically. And then look to where can you introspect? Where can you take time out, do a little retreat to bring things forward in this year? We're not long into the year, so it's a good idea to reflect back. Have I achieved what I've set out to achieve so far? Are there things that I can release and let go of? Because as soon as you do, the universe abhors a void. It will bring something forward to you. And this beautiful card with a gift from the gods of a brand new idea. And then remember, the thing about ideas is that if we leave them and we don't put them into action, all they do is ruminate around in our minds. They're unfulfilled. So if you've got an idea, something you've been working on, but it's time for a revamp, this is a perfect time to do it. These are beautiful cards for you, and I'm just going to fan them out for you one more time. Look at where the karma is done. Where are you finished with something? Not doing it like that ever again. Introspect a bit so that you've got some new way of thinking about it, because this new beginning is ours if we're willing to take the step. So I'm Shaman Weaver. I'm at East West Books on Thursday from 3:30 to 8:30. I'd love to see you. If I can be of service in any way, please let me know. ShamanWeaver.com. Aho. I'm going to give you a kiss and a whoosh. Shh. Blessings. Aho.